Dear students, I welcome you all for this class. Today we are going to see about the lesson Poets and Pancakes, was written by Asokamitran. Now let us see about the author Asokamitran. He was one of the most influential figures in the post-independent Tamil literature. He wrote more than 200 short stories and 8 novels. He was a famous essayist and critic. He won Sahitya Academy Award in 1996 for his collection of short stories, Appavin Snehithar. My Years with Boss. The author Asokamitran was worked in Gemini Studios and his duty was to cut out newspaper clippings on variety of subjects and store them in files. Asokamitran wrote about his experiences working in film industry in Gemini Studios, and he illustrated that in Weekly of India. These columns later became his book, My Years with Boss. So this lesson, Poets and Pancakes, is also extracted from the work of My Years with Boss. Here the boss referred to S.S. Vasan, the founder and the owner of Gemini Studios. Gemini Studios, one of the most influential film producing organization in India. Gemini Studios was set up in 1940 and it is located in Chennai. Next, pancake. What is pancake? Pancake was the brand name of makeup material. Makeup men use it to turn decent looking players into ugly looking monsters. Gemini Studios bought a truck of loads of pancakes. Greta Garbo, a Swedish actress, Miss Gohar and Vijayantimala, an Indian actress, also must have used the pancake materials. But the Radhi Agnihotri might not have heard of it. Next, the office boy. The makeup department had office boy, but he was a 40-year-old man. He was not a boy, he was a 40-year-old man. He believed that he had great talent. The office boy believed that himself he had a great talent, and he hopes to become a star actor, director, screen or lyric writer. So that he joined in Gemini Studios. But he was frustrated, he was irritated, and he blamed Kothamangalam Subbu always. The makeup room. The makeup department was in the upstairs building. The makeup room looked like a hair cutting saloon because it had large mirrors and lights. The large lights gave out intense heat. The makeup department was first headed by a Bengali who became too famous for a studio and left. A strict hierarchy was maintained in the makeup department. What was the strict hierarchy? The chief makeup man do makeup for hero and heroines, and the senior assistant makeup man do makeup for second hero and second heroine. Likewise, the hierarchy goes on. The office boy do makeup for the crowd players. The author at Gemini Studios. The author Asokamitran. The author's job appeared to be unimportant because he usually seen tearing newspapers and store them in files. Everyone would walk into his room and give him some work to do. The office boy also would come to recite his poem. Office boy wished to impress the author by his talent. And next, Kothamangalam Subbu. So already we know that the office boy was irritated and he was always blamed Kothamangalam Subbu. And who was Kothamangalam Subbu? He was very close to the boss, and the office boy was jealous of Subbu's nature. He had a better qualification than the office boy. Kottambangalam Subbu was a hard-working person and he also was a Brahmin. Kottambangalam Subbu had talents which he used for the advantages of the boss, and he would suggest number of practical ideas in presenting scene. The producer did not know how to do the scene. Subbu would come with many suggestions. Subbu was a good poet and novelist too. He wrote sprawling novel Thillana Mohanambal. Kottambangalam Subbu had created lifelike characters. He was an excellent actor, but he never aspired lead roles. He played minor roles. He acted better than main players. Subbu loved all his friends and his relatives, but the office boy only hated Subbu. And Kottambangalam Subbu was very close to the boss. Because of that, he was called as number 2 in Gemini Studios. The next story department. Kottambangalam Subbu was a member of story department also. He always seen with the boss S.S. Wash, and the founder of Gemini Studios. And beside the writers and poets in the story department was lawyer too. So lawyer is officially known by a legal advisor. The actress sometimes, who was not worldly wisdom, lost her temper on the sets. She spoke angrily against the producers. And next, anti-communism perception. Legal advisor, lawyers wore trousers, shirt and tie, sometimes coat too. So lawyers appeared or among the gaudy dressed poets and writers, because in Gemini Studios all the poets and writers used to wear gaudy dhotis except the legal advisor. The poets worshipped Gandhiji, though they had no connection to his ideas. They were averse to communism. They had a view that communists loved nobody. He was an revolutionary. Next, the arrival of Moral Rearmament Army, known as MRA. During this time, anti-communism were widespread in South India. MRA was a sort of anti-communism movement. So it visited Gemini Studios in 1952. In MRA Army, there were 200 people belonging to 20 nationalities. They presented two plays, Jotham Valley and Forgotten Factor. The Gemini family, the people are in Gemini Studios, 600 people, and the citizens of Madras were greatly impressed by their plays of Jotham Valley and Forgotten Factor. Their message was very simple, but the sets and costumes were excellent. For many years, Tamil cinema imitated the sunrise and sunset scenes presented by MRA. But MRA did not influence the outlook of the Gemini bosses. Next, visit to Englishman. A few months later, after the arrival of MRA, Gemini Studios received another guest. It was an Englishman. Nobody knows who he was. Some said he was a poet and some said he was an editor, but he was not the editor of any of newspaper in Gemini Studios here. The English man was welcomed by the boss, Mr. S.S. Watson. He gave a long speech. The English man gave a long speech on freedom and democracy in front of the people. But the speech of English man was not understandable by the people of Gemini Studios. And the visit of Englishman is also remain a mystery. and mystery solved. The author Asogamitran saw notice in the Hindu. In that notice, the Encounter, a British periodical, was organizing a short story contest. The author has never heard of the same periodical, The Encounter, but so that he wanted to send entry, but he wanted to have some information about the periodical The Encounter. So he visited to the British Council Library. There Asogamitran found copies of The Encounter. He learned that its editor was Stephen Spender, who visited the Gemini Studios earlier. After a few years, one day the author saw a pile of low-priced paperback editions of The God That Failed. He bought a copy for 50 paise. It contained 6 different essays, but all the 6 different essays were written by different writers. One of the writers was Stephen Spender. Now, the whole mystery of Stephen Spender's visit was cleared. And the founder, the owner of the Gemini Studios, Mr. Watson, was not interested in his poetry, but he was interested in Spender's views on communism. So this is what about the lesson Poets and Pancakes. In this lesson, the author Asogamitran discussed about his experience of working in Gemini Studios, and as well as many departments, makeup department, story department, and about Kothamangalam Subbu, and then MRA Army, and then visit of the English man, and this is what about the lesson. I hope you all understand the lesson, and thank you for listening. Thank you.